So I'm gonna take you guys along with me what a Friday is in my life. Kitty's so mad at me. She like barely let me hold her. She's so mad that I left town. If you guys saw that on Instagram, I left to Colorado for like 3 days. I thought I was going to Denver. Turns out my friends are in Boulder, which isn't that far off. I don't know how you feel about Denver. That was my first time in Denver. And the reason I say first time is because I have been to Denver before, but it was genuinely for like 12 hours. I think I went to breakfast at Snooze and then we went into like the Grand Central Station or something. And that was when I was maybe 23. It wasn't that long ago, but it was long enough. That was my first time in Denver. And all I remember was it had like a city vibe. But when I flew into Denver this time around, I wasn't as big of a fan. Boulder is super cute. I really liked Boulder. We went to a show at Red Rock. That was my first time at Red Rock. That was the whole reason I really went out there is my friends tend to summer. They summer in Boulder, Colorado. They're actually looking to buy a house out there. So when I went to go visit them, again, I was only there for 3 days, technically one full day. The main reason was obviously to see them. Also to go see Bonobo. Do you guys know who Bonobo is? It's more like house trance type music, which isn't usually my style. Usually if I'm doing more EDM, I like the headbang or more something like you could dance to. Going to Bonobo was still a lot of fun though. And I wanted to go to Red Rock. It is 7 a.m. and I'm meeting my friend at the gym. I'm just waiting on her and just kind of starting my morning with my matcha. I've been posting about this. I have switched over during the week to matcha. Matcha is an amazing anti-inflammatory. I have been doing a lot of anti-inflammatory foods. Food, drink. I'm still going to the doctor for my gut health. I've noticed my inflammation has gone down like crazy. Coffee will always be a thing for me. I think coffee is like, I love coffee, but feeling what it was doing to my body on a day-to-day basis for me doesn't mean it's happening to you, but for me, I switched over to matcha. I mean, look at the difference here. This is bloated after surgery, may I mind you. Even my surgeon was like, you look a little puffy. That's when it indicated to me, okay, it's something I'm doing at home then. Don't get me wrong, it takes 6 months total to heal after the surgery I got. But at this point in time, it's been what, 4 months? I should be a little bit more like less puffy by now, which again, that's what indicated to me it was what I was putting in my body. This is before, this is a week into matcha. This is the transformation. Not to say I haven't been doing other things. I've been making chia seed bowls. Chia seeds are amazing for anti-inflammatory. I've been making a lot of that stuff, eating a lot more fruit. I've just been putting a lot more things into my daily food intake to help with anti-inflammation. I don't like the word diet. I feel like that has, to me, a negative, is connotation the word? Connotation? A negative view. I just don't like the word diet. Ugh. I feel like it has triggered me in the past. Oh, I'm eating these certain foods only. I'm on this diet. I'm doing this new thing. That's all the new trends, you know, I've done them all. I'm just doing what works for me, honestly, at this point. But I have had a lot of you guys asking on my Instagram DM for more information on kind of what I've been doing for my gut health because I've seen such a transformation. Obviously, the surgery had to do some with it too, but really the food. Where is she? Her and I drive pretty much the same car and I don't see her car. I have the white version and she has the black version. She made it finally. I am in a lot of back pain and I think it's because I was carrying my bag. Here, I'll show it to you. This is my travel bag. I've had it since I was 19. I've had it for a long time and it's very, very sturdy. The zipper broke, but that's fine. Because I fly Frontier a lot, I don't want to pay extra for baggage. This is my personal item. It fits everything that I need. Because I can't roll it around, I have to put it on my back, on my shoulders, and like switch. And it's really heavy usually. Ooh, using my back in weird ways. I think I need a better form of travel, maybe. I probably won't do it though. Or it could have been that I was sleeping on the couch. Here's a little inside to my brain. I get scared really, really easy. For instance, if you guys ever see me at like an Airbnb, a hotel, I'm scared because I'm usually there alone. I'm just scared of something coming out and like attacking me. Not even a person, an entity. I'm just scared. Again, it's not even that I think I'm gonna see a person. I'm genuinely scared of a ghost. I'm terrified of ghosts, which is funny because I love Halloween. It's my ultimate favorite holiday. I have the ghost tattoo you guys have seen. I love fun, spooky, scary, nostalgic, spooky, scary, but you will not catch me watching scary movies unless they're nostalgic, like Halloween, like the movie Halloween. Nightmare on Elm Street, totally fine with those. But if it's a newer movie, it will f*** me up. I cannot watch them. One time I watched Hereditary. The moment that movie ended, I started bawling. What is this energy? Get it off me. I don't like it. I was bawling, like I said, for like an hour. I was not mentally okay for at least a month. I'm just really vulnerable to movies like that, which is why I don't watch them. And that's also why I don't watch shows like that either. So if there's like a really hot show, like Dahmer, for instance, I could not watch Dahmer. No way in hell am I watching Dahmer. I actually tried to. I got 3 minutes into the show and I immediately knew you are gonna have some twisted up shit going on in your head if you keep watching this. Shut it off. It is not worth it. I don't watch a lot of shows, movies. I haven't seen a lot of them, especially horror. I'm good. I really like more indie, comedy, anything that makes me feel good, I will watch that. But that's also why I watch a lot of reality TV. I do not want drama in my life. If you bring any sort of drama, you will not be here for long. I don't want to be a part of it, but I get my drama fill on reality TV. Even then, I'm a little sensitive to that because, you know, it's drama, and I'm not saying this for everybody, but for me, what I put into my head tends to become my reality. So I'm very careful with what I watch. That's pretty much what that comes down to. Going back to the couch. My friends had rented this house. Like I said, they go out there for the summer. So they had this beautiful historic home that they were staying in the historic district of Boulder. Beautiful two-story house. They had an extra room for me, but I was scared. So I slept on the couch. And that's just how I like it. What I was saying just a moment ago, anytime you guys see me at an Airbnb, if I'm alone, I'm most likely on the couch. I don't like being in a room where I can't see everything. I need to be able to visually see all aspects of what's going on if I were to open my eyes, because I'm just terrified. That's why I don't watch scary movies. I think that might be another reason to, full circle moment, why my back might be hurting, because that couch, for as big and grand as it was, it wasn't that comfortable. It was kind of hard. I like to sleep on my sides. Honestly, it could have been the couch and the bag as a whole. I just got back yesterday. Originally got a rental car because my friends are, you know, they're in Boulder. It's about a 40-minute drive from the Denver airport. Figured I'll get a rental car. That way I can like go to the gym when I'm over there. I don't have to worry about asking them for a ride. I don't have to get an Uber. I think it would be more expensive if I kept having to get Ubers and so I got a rental car. Pretty much didn't use that thing once. I used it to get from the airport and back to the airport. So next time I go, which will be next year, I will definitely not need a rental car, I don't think. Especially since where they usually stay is walkable to everything and they have their own car. I've been making a lot of my breakfast lately with ghee. This stuff is delicious. Himalayan sea salt is really good. Ghee in general has a lot of benefits. Huge fan of ghee. Also this just tastes so good. It's just eggs, egg whites, onions. I need to go grocery shopping. I always suggest to fill up on protein as much as you can first. It makes you full faster and it's really good for your body. And a little bit of hot sauce. Yummy. I'm thinking, let me grab the fork. I wanna change this area up a little bit. And you guys have seen me change it a lot, but it's because I'm trying to learn what I want. Here's the new and improved office space. The only thing I did was add a few photos, or a photo, I guess. I wanted it to be a little more cozy, add some decoration. Definitely still have a lot to do. In fact, I might also change up the desk itself. Here's kind of the vibe I'm going for. I want it to be more cottagey, nostalgic. Definitely doesn't look like that, but that's okay. You know what? I'm learning my style. Speaking of which, before I show you that, I want to show you this too. This area, I'm thinking what I want to do is I want to put that mirror in my room. Where that mirror is right now, I want to get a bigger one that's more like a full body mirror. And then maybe like a lounge area. I've noticed that Layla, whenever I'm cooking, Layla sits over here on my desk area a lot. Well, if we're going to utilize this space, I might as well make it a loungy area. I think that might be next on my vision, but I also switched up the living room. The couch used to be right along here, and then the TV was over here. We're going to hang the TV up right here. That, and put it right along right here. So I can like put little candles and stuff, TV above it. And then I move the mirror here. These are some little tea lights that go off at night. I'll have to show you guys tonight when they go off. I put like little tea lights everywhere so it looks more ambiance and cozy. And they go off on a timer. This one I'm testing out. I really do like it. I just need to set it up differently so that those aren't just chilling right there. Kitty's little area. I'm getting rid of these. Played their purpose. They're done now. For this area, I really want to do this. So you can see it would make it look, again, more cozy, cottagey. That's kind of the idea. Over here, I want to get rid of this rug. Maybe put that rug over in my office space area and put more of a darker vibe in here. I really want like that dark vampire-y cozy vibe. If I can find a photo of what I'm kind of wanting to embody, I'll put it here. And if not, here's an empty space. You can see I bought some pillows for the couch. I'm just trying to get more into like that darker vibe. I'm taking it step by step. So far it feels a lot more cozy in here, and it feels like this is more of a living room that's separate away from the rest of the house, which is exactly what I wanted. Before it was just so open that there was no privacy, I guess. I just wanted to switch it up a bit. And if you guys have not heard, I am staying in Arizona. I'm also going to stay in this apartment for another year while I save up for a house, potentially. I will be going to California just here and there whenever the agency that I'm now with wants me out there. That's what's happening with that. I'm very excited about it. I'm excited to make this place more of a home. The reason I never made it a home, I always thought that I didn't deserve to make it something I was proud of. I thought that it would be a waste of time, a waste of money, waste of energy. I'm just gonna move anyway. Why not just make the next place your dream place? With that, I never put time, love, energy into anything of what I did in the house. You're allowed to be proud of what you have now. Stop living for when I get there, then I'll be happy. You may never get there. I'm not gonna put that out there. Like, I'm gonna get there, but why can't you be happy now? Why? Because you don't deserve it? Because you're not there yet? Guess what? Let me tell you, if you keep living life like that, you're not gonna be very happy because you're not living in the moment of the things that you've worked hard for and that you have now. That's been a shift, which is why you guys have also seen me starting to decorate and learn how to decorate and like just learn how to do life skills. It's funny because when I started sharing my life on here, trust me, I know what it looks like. Her house isn't even a house, like what the but that's just how I was used to living. I was used to living so minimalist. I don't need it. I'm just gonna leave anyway. I'm gonna do a little bit of work, which I'm not gonna make you guys watch me do. And then after that, we're gonna do a hair mask. I did get a fresh set of extensions. So this time around, I really wanna take care of my hair better. I got extensions in June. I didn't take very good care of them. You know, they're real hair. So you still need to take care of them. For instance, you gotta oil them. You need to wash them, just like your hair. And I totally dropped the ball. I'm gonna wash this really quick. And I'm gonna show you guys my new rosemary hair treatment. I was doing this hair routine, which was rosemary hair oil and then jojoba oil. So the rosemary hair oil goes on the scalp. I would do a little massage and then I would do this oil on the rest of the hair. I've since switched it up, and that's because I have heard that rosemary hair oil, when applied to the scalp, can cause your scalp to clog. Can, not that it will. It can. I've been making, or I made, rosemary hair water. It's actually way easier to make than you would think. 3 cups of filtered water in a pot. 2 to 3 strands of rosemary, fresh rosemary. And I got mine at Whole Foods, duh. You let that boil, and then you let it soak for maybe an hour. And I made like a whole batch of it. Some of it is in my fridge. Here, let me show it to you. Rosemary hair oil, right here. And I also put it in here. Every day. What I've been doing is just spraying my hair with it. And rosemary is healing just in general as a plant. And on top of that, it has benefits of like helping the hair grow and heal and make it stronger. So when I was doing the rosemary hair oil twice a week, my hair was so beautiful. I mean, look at this photo. It was gorgeous. Since then, which when was that? That was like February of this year. Since then, I just kind of stopped doing it. Whatever, life gets in the way, or I guess a relationship. I kind of stopped doing it, and now I'm back on it because I've had these extensions in. Well, these are new extensions, but I've had extensions in since June, and when I got my other ones taken out, because I wasn't taking care of my freaking hair, my natural hair was a little bit thinner than normal. And again, that's because I was not doing the due diligence of taking care of my hair. Whereas this time around, I'm taking care of my hair. I want luscious, beautiful, long hair. And I want to get to a point where I don't need the extensions. I can just naturally have that luscious hair. And luckily, it's just water. So if you want to, you can do it every night. Kind of massage it in there. And it's not going to make you greasy. There's a little rosemary hack that you can do, and it's cheap. It's so cheap. It's like, what, $6 to make the whole bundle or the whole whatever, like this is gonna last me a while. And then we do the jojoba oil. I like this brand, and I do not recommend putting this at your tips because then you'll just get really oily, and again, it could clog. I would just do it more towards the middle and then the ends. And jojoba oil is great for the hair too. It helps to soften the hair, strengthen the hair. If you haven't noticed, rosemary is for new hair growth on the scalp. It gets to the new hair that's growing out. And then jojoba oil is to help with the dryness or the split ends, just to keep the hair that's already grown out more healthy. Put this all over my hair, and we're gonna leave this in for a few hours. Lately, I've been doing it at night, and I wear this silk cap when I go to bed. That way it doesn't get all over my pillow. I only wash my hair twice a week. Back to being single. I am now single, as you guys already know, very much aware. I shared this last week on the vlog, and I went into detail about why I'm single, what happened within the relationship, and I just share all of the details I can. If you guys have any questions, definitely go to that vlog because I go into a lot of detail. Moving forward from that relationship, I'm finding that I am taking a lot more care of myself. I was not ready to be in a relationship. As much as I tried and I wanted to be in a relationship. I just wasn't ready. Most of the relationships I've had in throughout my life have always been one right after another. I truly believe that that's why I never took the time to figure myself out fully, because to be blunt with you, I was relying on other people for my happiness. I had no need to figure myself out, because why would I? If I'm relying on other people for my happiness, I don't need to figure myself out. I'll just mold to you. And that's what I did for a long time. A lot of that has to do with childhood stuff, literally exactly what I talked about in last week's vlog. I'm tired of playing this role just because that's how I grew up and that's what I know. Doesn't mean I have to continue to live that way. And that's where I'm at now. When I met Ben, I was already there mentally. I already knew, like, no, I'm gonna find myself. This is me. I'm on my own journey. I am not going to be this other person for somebody I'm trying to date. I'm not doing that. I need to figure myself out. I want to know who I am. And that is how it was when I met Ben. So when I met Ben, it had nothing to do with me molding to him at this point. What it had to do with, though, was everything I discussed on the vlog last week. But one thing I do want to do is I want to thank you guys for taking the time to listen and not immediately just judge, for allowing me to really talk about what is going on in my head, in my life, in my feelings, and also giving me the space to be able to tell you guys at my own time. I had a lot of DMs prior to me even sharing any of that last week. Even then, the DMs were very kind. And everybody since then that has reached out has been extremely, extremely kind. Not only that, but they're either going through something similar or they've been through something similar. And it's just really nice to be able to have this community of girls and just people in general that I can talk to. Not to say that I don't talk to my own friends and my family about this day to day, but this whole journey of finding myself was to also be fucking real and talk to you guys about it too, and not be this simulated fucking robot that everything's perfect. It's not. Quite frankly, I don't know if I'll ever want it to be perfect. I've tried before to be perfect, and I'll tell you what, it's boring. This is just my way of being able to talk freely and hopefully build connections with you guys, because that's all I care about at this time, is building a community, being real. The whole social media pretending to be something you're not, in my eyes, is so outdated. I am so sick of it. Being myself and talking normally has always been a struggle. Always. Ever since, obviously, I was a kid. Childhood, duh. That's why I feel like I was so scared to make friends, because I felt like if I didn't fit into a certain mold or something that they wanted me to say, or if I didn't joke or make them laugh, they would look at me like, you're weird. Why is she even talking? Oh my God, one of my biggest fears is people talking about me in another room. If I go into a different room and I hear you guys whispering, my guard goes up. And you probably are talking about the and cheese dip, but my immediate reaction, red flag, they're talking shit about me. And again, this all just stems from childhood. These are all things that I'm trying to break. You guys already know I've been dabbling more so, not that I wasn't already, but more so in cannabis, edibles, or even like a little one hitter. I have noticed for me, those help me to step outside of my head, because I'm always like, there's voices telling me what I did wrong. I said something wrong. I'm always living in this fear of just It's all over the place in here. Cannabis has been really, really helpful to get me to be in the moment. Now that I'm seeing this version of being able to take a step back and be in the moment, I truly, truly feel like I've never been in that state of mind in my life. I have always been in a state of mind where it's crisis, anxiety, very much driven in a way that's not sustainable. And now I'm seeing a completely different side. What cannabis does for me is it helps me to be extremely in the moment, be extremely appreciative for all the things that I have, what I've worked for, the people in my life, myself. I am finding more and more self-love, and I'm just able to sit with myself. If you were to ask me maybe even 2 years ago, I truly hated myself. I hate's a strong word. I hated myself. Now I feel like I'm on this path. A lot of things are changing. And I remember I was so scared of change. What was I so scared of? I'm like excited for it now. Going back to what I was saying, having my friends invite me out to Colorado, Boulder, going out with friends tonight for a concert, having all of these people in my life that are such great people, but also just as hardworking, very much inspirational, just taking a step back and looking like you are who you hang out with. These are the people that you have in your life. Do you really think that they wouldn't want to hang out with you if you were not good enough? I don't think so. These are the type of people that want to be around people that also inspire them, that also give them good vibes. So that's also what I've been looking at lately, is taking a step back, seeing all the things that I have and what I'm grateful for, and really like finally seeing how others see me. Finally. I'm extremely grateful to finally be able to see that, because for so long, for 31 years, I have been extremely insecure in my own skin. I felt so insecure in myself, in my personality. I always wanted to be somebody else. I was always looking at somebody else like, oh, I wish I was her. And finally this year, before the breakup, but especially after the breakup, it's like, look, you truly have one body and you're in it until the day you die. So either buck up and start to really appreciate what you have, or don't. And life's probably not gonna go that well if you don't. I made that shift. I wanna be happy in my skin. I wanna be happy with who I surround myself with. I wanna live the dream life. I want to do everything that I can to make my life worth living, make it valuable, make it something that when I grow up, I am proud of what I've done. So that's where I'm at now. And again, not to say I wasn't there before the breakup, but after the breakup, significantly, it's come back down to this. And that's why I also am appreciative of the breakup. Because if it weren't for that, again, what I said last week is I am so codependent that I would have gotten to a point where I'm okay with who I am now. I think I'm good. But in reality, I don't want to just like be okay. I want to do the best that I can in this life that I have. So the breakup will always and forever be a huge blessing. And I do still talk to him. It's not something like, oh, that guy. I care for him a lot. We're still in communication. Oh my God, my entire toenail just came off. What? I went hiking like a few, it had to have been a few months ago, and my toe hit something. Like, that's f***ing gross. What I did notice was almost the f***ing second I posted that we broke up, the amount of men that DM'd me is truly disappointing. It's like, guys, I just broke up with somebody. I'm telling you guys the entire story and you have the audacity. Hey, I heard you're single now. It's like, let a girl breathe for a moment. Speaking of dating and blah blah blah. No, I'm not dating. I do not want to date. I actually want to take this entire, at least the rest of the year, to truly be on my own, work on myself. That's it. I don't want to entertain it. I don't want to spend any time potentially going on a date.
I'm gonna leave the hair oil in for like a few hours, but then, oh, also I'm eating chocolate covered cashews. I get these at Sprouts. Oh yeah, my sister Layla and I are gonna go see Goth Babe tonight. But right now, I'm just gonna get some more work done.
So this is what the house looks like. Ignore the dishes, please. We need to do that. But we have little lights that go off like that up there. Little one over there. And then there's the mirror, like I said earlier.
It's getting a vibe.
We went to Goth Babe last night and that was so fun. He puts on the best show. He gets the crowd interacted and in different ways, because this is my second time going to one of his shows. And what he did this time around compared to last time was almost entirely different. This time is he had the crowd split into two, you know, split into two. And then he brought one person up from each side and had them battle at Mario Kart. while all of us are watching and like cheering them on while he's playing the songs. It was so cool. Like, I'm getting chills. I think it's the best show I've ever been to, only because he is so interactive with his audience. Bok Babe as a whole has been a really, really big part of my life for the last, I want to say, 4 to 5 years. I used to use his music a lot in all of my reels. When I was using his music a lot is also when I was building my career path even like further than it is, or sorry, than it was. So it was when my career really started to get bigger. And a lot of that had to do with I was choosing music that fit the vibe, that fit the energy I was trying to capture. And his music just always did that for me. His story is really fucking cool. He has this story about how he was, I forgot the exact details, but I know it's something along the lines of he had some kind of neurological disorder. Something was going on with his brain. He quit school. He just started focusing on the things that make him happy, which was music. Here he is today. I just love that. Like, that right there is somebody who saw life for what it was and was like, you know what? No, I'm gonna do it different because I only have so long to live. So the show was great. And I did go with a few friends. Layla and I went together. And afterwards we just got home. But I will say, I'm feeling sick again. And I don't know why. I don't know what is going on with my body. I used to get sick a lot when I was vaping. Yeah, I used to vape. I was sober for a year and a half, I think. I picked up vaping. It's not the best, but you know what? That's what I did. And I would get sick a lot. And one day I just looked at it. This is disgusting. And I just chucked it. I don't like what it was making me feel like. I don't like what it was doing to my body. And I was getting sick all the fucking time. Cut that out. But recently, I'm wondering if it's my dishwasher, because I live in an apartment. Every single time I do the fucking dishwasher and it's done, I open it, it still smells like wet dog. So I'm almost wondering if it's the dishwasher, if it's just like not doing its job properly. I use that dishwasher daily. The last time I asked the apartment to check on it for me, all they did was put bleach in it. I need to call them again and see if there's potentially something going on in that dishwasher, because I am not kidding you. I'm getting a sore throat at least once a week, and that's not normal. I've been washing my straws, if you guys know about that. Only thing I can bring it back down to is the dishwasher. But until then, I'm gonna go get an acai bowl. I always get one when I'm sick. I go to Berry Divine and I get the Summit bowl. I did a question box asking you guys what you wanted to see out of my vlog this week. I did answer most of the questions throughout the vlog, so I just wanted you guys to know I did take you up on those questions, and I do appreciate you asking them. For some of the other questions that I saw, it was more so related to things to do in Arizona. My vlogs are more dedicated to my life, life updates, just more outside of my social media. My social media is definitely catered to my life as well, but also things to do in Arizona. So I will be answering those more so on my social media. So if you guys want to follow that, it is Southwest Sampler. I have a TikTok and Instagram. Obviously, I have YouTube here. Make sure to like this video, subscribe, and I have a new video going out every Sunday morning. With that said, if you guys ever have any questions or you want me to talk about anything in particular, share anything, let me know in the comments, or you can just DM me. I'm gonna go get my acai bowl, and I will see you guys next week.